Hello and namaste, welcome back to my channel. Today in this video we are going to create user dem data, and we'll be using this dem data to create a contour, hillside, slope from this dem data. So for that case I have a dem data downloaded as a dem dev, and if you want to download this data I will give the link in the description. You can download from that link, and for that case I have this area of interest where I will be using my dem data to create those slope aspect and contour from this dem. Okay, now we'll move to the subject. For that case I will first of all make this as a hollow, and then we'll use extract by mask feature to mask this data. So for that case I'll go to spatial analysis tool, and then from here we have extraction option, and here extract by mask, and then I'll give the input raster as this dem, and then raster as ferihola. So I'll save this as this, and we'll go do okay. Okay, it will take some time. Okay, this is our extracted area. We don't need this previous stem, so we'll remove this stem as a remove. And then now first of all we'll also, we don't need this also. Okay, we'll also remove this, and then now then we'll go to our first, we'll have the dem data. Okay, so for dem data we'll create a slope. So for creating the slope we'll go to same spatial analyst tool, and then inside the spatial analyst tool we have surface. Inside the surface we can see here aspect, contour, cut fill, hillside, slope. So okay, so for this case we'll first of all do slope, and then in slope okay we'll enter the input raster as extractive, and then output raster will be same. Okay, degree will be will go with percent rise. Okay, so you can either take degree or you can take percent rise. Okay, so for this case we'll go with percent rise, and then method will be planar, and then z value will be 1. Okay, after that we'll do okay. It will take some time for the processing, and you can see the slope value. So inside the slope value you can see here we have slope interval of 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Okay, so for the, again if you want to change this interval you can go to properties and inside the property you can see symbolization, and then we'll change the class to, we can change, okay we'll change it to 5, and then after classify here, sorry, so okay, and then label we'll go to format, inside the label format label will have percentage, okay, no numeric significant digit will go to okay 4, okay 3 will go, okay, and then okay, so it will label as 0.29 0 to 29.3 29.4 48.8, and then okay you can change the color from here, you can choose any color ramp you want. Okay, we are okay with this, and then we'll apply this. So you can see the label value as 0 to 29.3. in this way it will manage our slope. Okay, after this we'll be using what we call this aspect value to create the aspect. So if you don't know about the aspect, we want to say that this aspect is something when you have this slope and you don't know the direction, we use this aspect value to show the direction of the slope. So it will start from zero north, true north direction, that will be 0 degree, and in clockwise direction it will go back to that same direction as 360 degree, and we can select this aspect, and we'll select this as we'll select the same dem data, and we'll be using planar method, and we'll do okay. it will create the aspect of that value. So here you can see, you will this you can see aspect, and then it shows the aspect from 0 to 22.5 degree as north, northeast, east, southeast, south, southwest. And okay, so where the flat surface will be shown as -1, and this color will represent the flat surface, and other will represent the direction of the slope from north to back to, from north to 0 to 360 degree and back to north, same direction. It will show different colors of the shadows, sorry, shadows, not shadows, direction of the slope. Okay, after that, if you want to create a shadow effect in the slope, okay, it may be used while creating a topo map, or we'll be doing the same with hillside. Okay, hillside will be used to create the shadow effect, and it will create the hillside. And we can see, okay, so our shadow depends upon the direction of the sun and the altitude of the sun. Okay, so for the direction of the sun, we'll be using 0 to 360 degree, and for the altitude, we'll be using 0 to 90 degree. So for that case, we'll be using 315 default value, 315 degree and 45 degree, and we'll be using z factor as 1, and then we'll do okay. So it will create a shadow effect from the dam. Okay, so you can see the shadow effect. It will be, so the shadow effect through the help of dam, and on the basis of the elevation and direction of the sun, it will create the slope. So 254 to 0 is the slope value. Okay, so more bright means more flat surface, and 0 means most shadow, the portion that receives the most least sun is the 0 value, and most sunlight is the high value. So it will create the shadow effect on the our data. So after this, we'll be using this stem value to create a contour. So for that case, we don't need this hillside. So here you can see the same contour here, and we'll create the contour. Input raster will be our dam data, and the contour interval, we will, for this case, we'll create the contour interval of 100, and then base contour will be always be 0, and one will z value will be 1, and this maximum vertices per feature, we don't need this. Then after that, we'll create, do okay. So it will create a contour. So you can see the contour here, and then if you want to create a different level of contour, you can colorize on the basis of the contour value. So for that case, we'll go to properties, and then inside the symbology, we'll be going with categories, and then on the basis of contour, sorry, category, not quantities, maybe. Okay, value will be contour, and then we can change the value on the basis of, we can create now number of classes. So we'll go with 4 classes, and it will create a number of equal contour values, 800 to 1100, 1110 to 1400, and it will use different color to symbolize this contour lines. So you can see here, you have different contour labels symbolized on the basis of the contour value. So we can also label the features. So we'll use contour to label, and then we'll apply. So it will show the contour value when we do it, label feature enabled from this table. So it will show the contour value here in your dam data. So you can see, and this is the contour shown in the shown and prepared using the dam data. Okay, so in this way, you can create a aspect, hillside, viewside, sorry, hillside, slope, and contour from the dam data. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope this video was useful very much. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.